Hi guys, we'll start our first exercise now. So our first exercise will be about basic circuits connection. So make sure that after you have logged in, you have already chosen into the circuits section. Then after that, click create new circuits. After that, you are entering the workstation for building your circuits. The very first thing you need to do is to make sure that you go to the top left section and then change the name to exercise 1.1. Press enter. You will notice that the exercise name has been changed to exercise 1.1. So in our basic circuits connections exercise today, we'll do two very simple connection. The first of which is to connect a battery to a light bulb. So by first dragging this 9 volt battery over here into the screen, so you will be able to place the 9 volt battery into your workstation now. So once you place that, you can name it or you can rotate it using the button on the top left section. Once you have done that, now you need to go to the search function and then type in either light or bulb. Okay, then the image of light bulb will be show up over here. Then you can now drag light bulb into your screen to place the light bulb over here. So you have now placed 9 volts battery and the light bulb over here. Now all you need to do is to connect the two of them. So how to connect the two of them? We don't have a wire over here, so all you need to do is actually just go to the design screen and then look for the terminal. Terminal is basically the part where you start connecting from those parts. So you can see on the light bulb there's two terminals over here, and then on the battery there's two terminals over here as well. All you need to do now is the light bulb don't have any positive or negative parts, so all you need to do is now rotate to the part that you need. Okay, then after that you can directly connect one terminal to the negative part, another terminal to the positive part, then press start simulation. Then you will be able to see that the light bulb lighting up. This is basically a very simple demonstration on how electricity works. All you need is a source, for example this 9 volt battery, and then have it connect to your light bulb. For electricity to move, you need to have the part connect to the light bulb flowing through it, and then the electricity have to go back. So it create a loop, basically a circle over here, then the electricity will be able to flow through. This is just a very simple experiment to show you how electricity works, but we are now moving on into the next, which is the most important bit. So remember to press the stop simulation button on the top right corner. Now you need to go in here and look for something called Arduino, or basically you can just type in over here UNO. There'll be a lot of things coming up, but we only need this one called Arduino Uno R3. You drag it into the screen as well. Okay, so on this Arduino R3 will be what we'll be learning for upcoming few months. Basically, it is a programmable microprocessor. If you didn't know what it is, don't need to afraid now. It basically means that it has a lot of these parts called terminal that you can connect to different parts and use program to control it. So if you wonder why we are learning electric things in your STEM class, it's because this thing can be used to code. Okay, so if you notice over here, when you press code, this block come in is similar to what you have learned in M block, which is why we have been learning M block. It is to get you used to controlling block before we come to Arduino Uno. Now press code again to close the codes section, and now I want you to put in another light bulb. So once you drag in another light bulb, The first thing I want you to do is to just connect it to a power source and make sure that it works. So other than this 9-volt battery, the Arduino Uno can actually be act as a power source as well. So it doesn't have to always connect to this port. The port that have number, including this 0 to 13 and this A0 to A5, are the one that can only be used after you program it. But over here, we have 5 volts and 3.3 volts. Okay, these two are the two that you can connect to act as a power source directly. So we first draw a line starting from 5 volts. So click once over here, drag down a little bit, okay, then go to where the bulb is and connect it. Okay, then like I say, it doesn't only need to have a source coming in, but it have to go back as well. So where does it go back to? This thing called GND. So GND is actually the negative terminal of the Arduino Uno board. So in order to make it work, you also have to start from GND, click, drag down a little bit, go all the way to another terminal. So once you connect that, when you press start simulation from top right corner, the light bulb should light up as well. This concludes everything that we need to do for exercise 1.1. So make sure you have already changed the name to exercise 1.1. This file will be automatically saved in your dashboard. But before that, make sure that when you put start simulation, both of the light bulb can light up. You can do other optional things, for example, you can rearrange them or you can change the color of the wire. All of these are up to you. You can also name them or do anything, but just make sure that when you press start simulation, both light bulb will be lighting up. So once you press stop, go to top left corner and press at this logo. You will notice that the exercise 1.1 is now saved in your account. So I can access this exercise anytime to check on your progress and mark your homework. So make sure that you have done that. So today's conclusion. We'll be using TinkerCAD to simulate real world circuits during this MCO. And then all circuits only work when there's a source that connected to the part that need electricity, and then must connect back to create a loop. Arduino Uno is a basic programmable microprocessor that can be used to control electronic parts. So we'll see you on next exercise.